Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and up to ages of ages.
Amen.
O heavenly King, Comforter, Spirit of Truth, who is everywhere present and fill us all things, treasury of blessings and giver of life, come and abide in us, cleanse us from every stain, and save our souls.
Oh,
exist my soul, there's no salvation within God. The thou art Lord God, my help, my glory, and lift your up my head. I cry unto the Lord with my voice, and hear me out into the mountain. And I do not say, I will, the Lord will help me. I will not be afraid of 10,000 people, but set myself against your wrath about. Arise, O Lord, save me, my God, thus, and call God, cause my enemy. The teeth of sinners have suffered, and the salvation of the Lord is the presence of my people. And I do not say, I will, the Lord will help me. O Lord, if you do not, then I can refuse me my wrath, so that I am surpassed in you. And now I do not have heavenly funding. There is no sin in my flesh in the face of my wrath, and there is no peace in my bones in the face of my sin. For my iniquities are required in my head, as every burden of the cross have been upon me. I reach you have learned to corrupt the face of my folly. I have impression of the dark out in the end, all the long of the dark out faces. So my Lord to fill the block and is no good in my flesh. I have lived in holiday seasonally. I have roared and roared in my heart, a load of running on my desire, my glory set in me. My heart is troubled, my strength is filled, and the light of my eyes is against the sun. My friends, my neighbors, you know, I am against the sin, my ears and things are far off. The day that sought after my soul is violence, and that some evil to me spake vain things, crowned with all the alarm and meditate. But I ask you never death, I will go to God, as the scriptures never go to God's mouth. And I became as a man of pure thought, and I have this mouth there to be proved. Worthy of my hope, the Lord, thou art with me, O Lord my God. And so that never my name is rejoicing, and gave my name to shake it. Those men spake those words in this name. For I am ready to discourage my sorrows continually before you. Well, if ever my enemies do not take heed, which is what I said. But my enemies that have been stronger than I, they have taken unjustly multiplied. They that have been to me, who have slain me because of his goodness. Forsake me now, Lord my God, depart not from me, be attentive unto my call. O Lord, my salvation. Forsake me now, O Lord my God, depart not from me, be attentive unto my call. O Lord, my salvation. O God, my God, be ever rooted in my soul, first to thee. While we have my flesh on their feet, my bearing and proud and watching. So in the sanctuary, the Lord is to be proud of their glory. For thy mercy is greater than life, and I shall praise thee, so shall I bless in my life, and my name on death of my hands. And the mirror of that is that my soul will go. O living joys which are my house, praise thee. If I remember that my bed, and thou have meditated on me, and thou art my helper. In the shelter that waits till I rejoice, and so I plead after thee. Thy right hand hath been put to help me, and I ask for ease of being, and I sought after my soul. They should go down into the bed of the parts of the earth, which should be surrendered unto the edge of the sword. Forces of the shall they be. For the king should be glad about it, and should be praised as glorifying him, and found with them to stop and speak to unjust things. As the dawn meditated on thee, the dog become my helper, and the shelter that wins will I rejoice. My soul hath leaped after thee, thy right hand hath been put to help me. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Lord God of my salvation, by day I cry by night before thee, but my prayer come before thee, bow down thy ear and my supplication. For filled with evils is my soul, my life, and the deeds come from high. I am counted with them that were down in the dead, I become as a man, and I fell free from among the dead, like the bodies of the slain that sleep in the grave, whom thou rememberest no more, nor cut off my hand. They made me the lowest pit of darkness and shadow of death. Against me is thy anger made strong, and all thy fellows cast their rod upon me. Thou hast removed my friends apart from me, they have made an abomination unto themselves. I have been delivered up and have not come forth, my eyes are weak from poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, the whole day long, I have stretched out my hands unto thee. They of the dead will doubt with wonders, or shall physicians raise them up, and they give thanks to thee. Nay shall any in the grave tell of thy mercy and thy truth and thy destruction. Nay shall thy wonders be known in that darkness and thy righteousness in that land that is forgotten. But as for me and thee, O Lord, and my cry, and in the morning shall my prayer come before thee. Wherefore, O Lord, dost thou cast off my soul and turn thy face away from me? A poor man am I, in troubles from my youth. Yea, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Thy fury is cast upon me, and my fear is so sorely troubled. Yea, came around me about like water all days, yea, long and compassed me back together. Thou hast removed apart from me by the neighbor and my acquaintance, and because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, by day I cry and by night before thee.
Let my prayer come before thee, God, God, my dear blessing. Bless the Lord, O my soul, all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, forgive not all that I have done with thee, who is gracious unto all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, fulfilled thy desire with good things. Thy youth shall be renewed as the eagles. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth judgment for all thy wrong. He hath made his ways known unto Moses and the sons of Israel, and things that he healed. Compassion and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous in mercy. God, if at the end will be angry with you, and your eternity will be wrong. God, according to our iniquities, have you dealt with us, neither according to our sins, have you rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven and the earth, the Lord has made his mercy prevail over them and through them. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath removed our iniquities from us. Like as the Father hath compassion upon his Son, so hath the Lord had compassion upon him and through him. We know it whereof we are made, yet remember that we are dust. As for man, his days are as the grass. As the plough of the field, so shall he plough the field. For when the wind is passed over, then it shall be gone, and no longer will it know the place thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity upon him that feareth him. And his righteousness is upon sons of sons, upon him that keep his testament, and remember his commandments to them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, his kingdom will rule over all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, might and strength, that perform his word and hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all you his hosts, his ministers that do his will. Bless the Lord, all you his works, every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. In every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear to my supplication, thy truth. Hearken unto me in thy righteousness. And answer not to the judgment of thy servant, for thy sight shall know that heaven be judged upon. The enemy has persecuted my soul, they have humbled my life down to the earth. He has set me in darkness of those that have long been dead, and my spirit within me has become despondent. Within me my heart is troubled. I remember the days of old, I meditated on all thy works, I ponder on the creation of thy hands. I stretch forth my hand unto thee, my soul thirsteth after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit hath fainted away. Turn not that face away from me, lest I be like them that go down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for thee I put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way where I should walk, for thee I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and thee I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall take me to the land of brightness. For thy name's sake, O Lord, shalt thou live me. In thy righteousness shalt thou bring my soul out of affliction. And in thy mercy shalt thou utterly destroy my enemies. And now shall cut off all them that have put my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and do not to the judgment of thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and do not to the judgment of thy servant. Thy good spirit shall make me a land of greatness. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, from now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O our God and our hope, glory to thee.
Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Ben, God's name in necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, so God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, O Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, now call all sinners and Virgin Marys, and all the saints, let us commend ourselves to each other, our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For unto thee are due glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
half deaf, a stranger, then bound, and captive, and defeated. And all those peace cried out through thy reviving resurrection. Verily Christ the life giver is risen for thee, careful that.
Both now and ever, and to ages of ages, amen. The mystery was the same for everlasting, was unknown of the angel of the angels, but revealed to thee to those who dwell upon this earth. And that God had to want to become incarnate and unconfused union of his own good will, accepted the cross for our sake, whereby he raised again the first created and hath saved our souls from death.
Now it is rise from the tomb, O Christ Savior, our God, because thou art not this. And now it is raised with thee thy word by thy resurrection and discharge the line of death. Proclaim the resurrection call. Wherefore do we glorify thee, O thou who alone art merciful and the lover of mankind.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Gabriel the 17th is a blind height wrapped in a white robe, came to the stone, where the rock of life was, and shouted to the weeping women, saying, cease your wailing and crying, and receive these smile of joy, with comfort. For he whom he saved you is in very prison. Therefore, thou wilt proclaim to the apostles that the Lord is risen.
For now and ever, and to ages and ages, amen. All the ranks of the angels, O thou who art undefiled, have been dazzled by the secret of thy dreadful work here. And all men, that the all encompassed, that the all encompassing as sign for him was encompassed in thy bosom as day, and he who was before eternity received a temporal gain, and that he who heeded their living breath with his ineffable goodness was glory to know. Wherefore did they glorify thee with praise, for thou art truly with their purpose.
Thank you.
Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
From the tomb, for trembling and astonishment had come upon them, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid.
Of Moscow and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn,
of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the Merchant, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Venus the Wonder Worker, of the Hierarchus Ignatius, the God Bearer of Antioch, Aranamos and Eutyrios, of the holy, glorious, great women, martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kyriaki, Fotini, Marina, Pers, Eva, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, bright, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy, glorious, and bright, victorious martyrs, Adrian and Natalie of Nicomedia, Venerable Jalasa, Prince of India, and Venerable Avian of Anjutsal, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
They spoke to him concerning the blessedness of the righteous and the kingdom of God.
Now the treaty of the cross has blossomed forth with might and steadfastness to the hitherto barren truth.
Thank you.
us have mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, O Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious name, and of all hosts, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God.
Through
the prayers of our Holy Father, Lord Jesus Christ, our
his holy suffering. Truly true, both these things now was quiet and true. Wherefore today we the faithful honor thy divine before me.
Thank you. Return
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States and also authorities and corrupt forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Kevin, Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance, O Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Most Holy, Sacred Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and build our life unto Christ our God.
Lord, how can we give you all glory, honor, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
To sing to thee, alleluia.
future, from now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Holy begotten Son and immortal Word of God, who for our salvation is willing to be incarnate.
Thank you.
wisdom, let us attend.
Brethren, be watchful, stand firm in your faith, be courageous, be strong. Let all that you do be done in love. Now, brethren, you know that the household of Stephanas were the first converts of Achaia, and they were devoted themselves to the service of the saints. I urge you to be subject to each man and to every fellow worker and laborer. I rejoice at the coming of Stephanas and Fortunus and Achaios, because they have made up for your absence. For they refresh my spirit as well as yours. Give recognition to such men. The churches of Asia send greetings. Apollo and Prisca, together with the church in their house, send you hearty greetings in the Lord. All the brethren send greetings. Greet one another with a holy kiss. I, Paul, write this greeting with my own hand. Any one has no love for the Lord, let him be accursed. Our Lord, come. The grace of the Lord Jesus be with you. My love be with you all. In Christ Jesus. Amen.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
To get his fruit. And the tenants took his servants and beat one, killed another, and stoned another. Again he sent other servants, more than the first, and they did the same to them. Afterward he sent his son to them, saying, they will respect my son. But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, this is the heir. Come, let us kill him and have his inheritance. And they took him and cast him out of the vineyard and killed him. When therefore the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants? They said to him, he will put those wretches to a miserable death and let out the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the fruits in their season. Jesus said to them, have you never read in the scriptures, the very stone which the builders rejected has become the head of the corner? This was the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Intended, and only increased the rebellion against him,
persecuting and killing the prophets he sent to correct them. Alas, of course, we know God sent his only begotten Son, full of grace and truth, to save his people from their sins. And yet the sons of those wicked men were filled with envy and wrath and conspired together to put him to death unlawfully. Even as our Lord stood there and foretold his pending demise at the hands of these men, and they were present listening, our Lord did not condemn them or pass any sort of judgment. Instead, he asked them, in the context of this parable, what do you suppose the landowner will do when he returns? And the people responded on their own, he will miserably destroy those wicked men and let out his vineyard to other tenants who will pay him the fruits in their season. Kind of interesting that these people, in the midst of their sin, could even recognize that what they were doing was wrong in the context of a story. You know, as long as it was somebody else, they were free to condemn. But, of course, their own words condemn them, we might say, because within that same generation, utter destruction came upon Jerusalem, and the kingdom of God was taken from the former tenants and given over to the Gentiles, that they might produce the fruit necessary to glorify God. Well, this is obviously not a politically correct story, yet it is one that must continue to be told even in our generation, because the kingdom of God will never be the property of any one group of people. Not the Greeks, not the Arabs, the Serbs, not the converts, anyone. The New Testament scriptures also contain stories of Christian churches suffering rebuke, and even in some cases having lampstands removed, the presence of God's glory removed from them because of their disobedience to the truth. People of the church are just as likely to turn away from God as the people of Israel were. So the first lesson here seems to be that we who call ourselves God's people must never assume that our status is chiseled in stone and can never be revoked. God is faithful and cannot deny himself or his promises. But the same cannot be said of us. Only those who love the truth and nurture that into fruitfulness of soul will abide as the righteous tenants in God's vineyard. Another obvious thing that I think we should note about this story is that the church is likened to a vineyard, and we to laborers. We are not vacationers in the vineyard of God. We aren't, you know, at a wine tasting party or something like that. The parable implies that we are there to work, and to work together with God to produce the fruit by which ultimately our labors will be judged. The church does not primarily exist to serve as a social club, or as an emotional support group, or as a Sunday school, or even as a Bible study or a center of religious teaching. These things are fine maybe and have their place, but the vineyard exists for one principal reason, and that is to produce fruit. That's the reason it exists. And to produce spiritual fruit is the purpose of the church, producing that fruit in the lives of those who labor within it. And I would hope that we have at least some idea of what those fruits are. Scriptures list many: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control are among the fruits of the Spirit. Long-suffering, modesty, and chastity are also included. Faith, knowledge, self-control, patience again, godliness, brotherly affliction, and mature love are the fruits that St. Peter describes in his second epistle, adding, "For if these qualities are yours and are increasing, they render you neither useless nor unfruitful in the true knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ." Who among us would want to be remembered by the writing on our tombstone,
which said, "Here lies so-and-so, a really nice guy, but pretty much useless and unfruitful in his knowledge of Christ." You know, I don't think anyone would want to be remembered that way. So it is important that we don't live that way, you know. It is very important that we recognize that now is the time to labor in God's vineyard. We aren't here to be entertained, to relax, or just because we like getting up early on Sundays. We are here for a purpose, and our whole life reflects that purpose of producing the fruit of the Spirit by our cooperation with God, by our self-sacrifice and obedience. The time is now to bring forth fruit for our Master, who will be looking for it and will be expecting it in that day to come. We must always give strict attention to our repentance, turning from the urgings of the flesh to worship the living God in purity of heart. It is the time to be kind and considerate and to minister to others and not to ourselves alone, to be gentle and patient with people, not given to frustration or anger, to cultivate prayer and an abiding trust in God, turning from unbelief and a misplaced hope in worldly things. You know, so often we're occupied with stuff, things, money, whatever, and so little occupied with God and so forth. You know, in ancient Israel, the struggle was idolatry versus the true God, right? God was always saying, "You're turning aside to these false gods." Well, it's the same in ours. It's just that our false gods aren't Molech or Baal or some other, but, you know, the almighty dollar or vacation time or convenience or whatever. We are even ourselves and our flesh and our desires. We serve so many idols that we must turn from to serve the living God. We must show generosity in our tithes and offerings as evidence that we are seeking the world to come and the earthly treasure that will be repaid a hundredfold, and aren't just storing up treasures for ourselves where moth and rust destroy and thieves break in and steal. It's funny how we will read that thing and say, "Oh, tis, tis," you know, and then do that very thing. And how do I know? It's because unfortunately, I don't do this, but maybe once every couple of years, but I'm required by our constitution to look at the giving records in order to qualify parish council members, because we have elections coming up, and I see who gives and how much and who don't and how little. And it's I feel sometimes like I must be failing to communicate how important it is that we give, even if we're giving a small amount, but giving it meaningfully and sacrificially. It is important that we give, because we are not worshiping God. We are not recognizing Him truly, and we are serving idols if we do not give. You can't not give to God and declare yourself a worshiper of God. So it is important that we give. And when I see smoke rings behind people's names, that's zeros, you know, for those of you who don't follow baseball. Vince Scully, I think, came up with that one. And it's just not good. We need to change that. And it's not just me, you know, wanting to make portion payments or whatever, you know that. But it's because this is how we worship God. The fruit that the Master will soon return to collect is ultimately really our own souls. And will they be adorned with beauty, with love, with nurturing and cherishing of Him, you know, throughout our life? Or will we be ripped away from those things that we really love most of all, and, you know, suffer that terror at that moment of judgment? Let us not neglect our labors or waste our time pursuing vanities. This is our time to abide in Christ and to bear much fruit. To the glory of God, the Father, the Son,
by thy grace, wisdom,
that guarding always by
armies and our armed forces everywhere. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Servants of God, especially for the Archpriest Wayne, for Wanda, Teresa, Peter, Michaela, for Colleen and her family, for Karen, Val, Stella, Donald, Gary, Pat, Araskeva, for Wayne, for Anna, Nadia, Angela, and Destiny, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and remission of their sins. The Lord God, remember that in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, and especially for Kevin and Seraphim, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
be to all.
And to thy spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one accord we may confess.
Many eyes soared above, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn. for the remission of sins. Having in remembrance, therefore, this saving commandment, and all those things which have come to pass for us, the cross, the grave, the resurrection on the third day, the ascension into heaven, the session at the right hand, and the second and glorious end. Of thine own, we offer unto thee, in behalf of all and for all. Savior Jesus.
Jesus Christ be with you all.
Holy, holy, holy.
St. Barnabas, perhaps for the first time this day. We invited to join us afterwards for a coffee hour, but we are not allowed to serve communion to those who are not participating members of the Eastern Orthodox Church.
With the fear of God and faith and love, draw near.
Thank you.
Lord, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. through his grace and love towards man, always now and ever and unto ages of ages. By the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy glorious and all honorable apostles, of our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, Adrian and Natalie of Nicomedia, the venerable Joasaph, the Prince of India, and the venerable Adrian of Anbrutzov, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he has put in love us mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
At this time we will have our monthly memorial for our loved ones who have passed away in the month of August, either this August or previous.
Thank you.
mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy. For the repose of the souls of the servants of God, Larry, Gabriel, Spiro, Maria, Evangelos, David, Mimi, Constantine, Anna, Helen, Violet, Martha, Betty, Betty, Elizabeth, Suzanne, Marianne, Francis, Mimi, Chris, George, Evangelisa, Georgia, Helen, Theodore, Xenny, Despina, Terry, and Betty, Heaven, Seraphim, depart in this life, and that thou wilt pardon their every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord,
that the Lord God will establish their souls where the just repose, the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and remission of their sins, let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and our God.
Grant this, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death and made powerless the devil and given life to thy world, do thou the same, Lord, give rest to the souls of thy departed servants. Larry, Gabriel, Spiro, Maria, Evangelos, David, Mimi, Constantine, Anna, Helen, Violet, Martha, Betty, Betty, Elizabeth, Suzanne, Marianne, Francis, Mimi, Chris, George, Evangelista, Georgia, Helen, Theodore, Zini, Despina, Terry, Anne, Betty, and the newly departed, Kevin, Seraphim, in a place of brightness, a place of verdure, a place of repose, whence all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. Pardon every sin which he hath committed, whether by word, or deed, or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind. For there is no man that liveth that sinneth not, and thou only art without sin, and thy righteousness is to all eternity, and thy law is true. For thou art the resurrection and the life, and the repose of thy departed servants, O Christ our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, together with thy Father, who is from everlasting, and that all holy, good, life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace and blessed Theodokos, who art most holy, save us. Departed this life in his holy mansions, and number them among the just, and have mercy upon us, forasmuch as he is good and lovest mankind. May thy memory be eternal, Lord, ever memorable, brethren, who art worthy of blessedness.